Show me how I stepped on the ball. Show me how I stepped on the ball.
Look.
When he killed it there.
That's terrible.
I've seen this a lot of times.
That is terrible.
Lippy.
Stumped on the ball.
That's terrible. I'm not going to lie.
Lippy.
You stepped on the
Lippy,
ball.
Do you know what a good touch? Do you know what a good touch does? Yeah,
Lippy, that's terrible.
A good touch, a good,
Lippy, that's terrible.
A good touch makes your next move easy.
It is terrible. It's terrible.
Filthy at Five, number one football podcast in Zambia, the number one sports podcast in Barbados. The number one football podcast in Bermuda.
Another black country.
The number one sports podcast in Nepal.
Another black country. Asian country.
The number two football podcast in South Africa.
Black and white country.
Is it
The number two football podcast in Finland.
White country.
Finnish.
Number two podcast in the United Arab Emirates.
What? Shukran Habibis.
And the number two football podcast in Nigeria.
Black country.
That makes sense.
Could it, all right, let's be clear.
Pick up all the ethnic minorities and
let's
Finland.
Let's be clear, could have been Congo.
Were there any Asians there?
I don't know if they got Wi-Fi.
Were there any Asians there?
Jeez.
When the president's
yeah,
in
Nepal.
A mood.
Nepal. Have you seen Nepal's flag? It's wavy. What's it it's like that.
This episode of Filthy at Five is brought to you in partnership with Stereo, the live podcasting app. We're going to be on
whoa,
there.
Whoa. You didn't tell me that.
We've been on there a couple times already. No,
I'm on there. Follow me.
Click the link in the description to download the Stereo app. Live podcasting. We're on there. Here's a clip from the last live we did on Stereo, just so you guys can familiarize yourself with the show.
Stereo.
Between 5 and 11, 12, I'd say your dad's your hero. Like, you think your dad can be everyone's dad. You go into school saying, my dad will have your dad.
Facts. I used to my dad.
Yes. I used to tell people that, hey, my dad will have your mum. What are you talking about? That's how... Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, yeah, bruv, man. It's seeing that him take the L, even when, like, if he shouts at you an hour later, you're going to look at him like, but dad, I just watched you lose. You can't shout at me now. Because you can have him now. It's an L, man.
I left a little bit before that. Oh my god.
Oh, did you? You left at 1-0.
Yeah, I just heard the breakdown of it, innit? I just heard the breakdown of it. A man saying like, yeah, he touched it, boom, boom, boom. So obviously just going by the rule book, it is what it is. Watching that with my own two eyes, that was a bit mad still. Did he touch him? Did he actually touch him?
Yeah. No, he touched him. Yeah. He's trying to run across, but it's like just stop. Just stop, because you've done this before, Luis. You've done this before.
Yeah, he's got form still. He's got form.
I feel like he's still in his head. He was trying to be tricky and, like, foul him, stop the goal, and then the referee be like, oh, you didn't mean it, though, David. Don't worry about it.
Oh, mate.
All right, this week, and I wanted to do this last week, but I needed to make sure the numbers were right and the names were right. And that Lippy was here to absorb it.
I tried, big Y.
I went to the crowd and said, crowd, what have been the biggest howlers in the history of Filthy at Five? Obviously, there's howlers, there's Poet and Miles. Mm-hmm. But that's a howler. I'm talking about howlers where people's opinions went left. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about howlers where time has proved people super wrong.
Yeah.
And luckily, I've got the data. I've got the facts. I've got the votes. Listen, there's stuff I don't remember. So I went to Twitter. I went to YouTube. I went to Instagram to ask. And we got some back. And we're going to answer for them today.
Yeah, I got the answers. Because I know about 8 of them and me. So it's nothing.
Serious?
Probably. I know what this is, Paul. I know this guy. It's going to be none of his howlers.
It's a lot. No. By the way, I've never had a howler.
You've never had a howler?
No. People think I've had a howler, so I'm here to defend my non-howlers that I've never had. That's what I'm saying. This first one comes from Shades. You know Shades, he's that Chelsea fan who raps about Chelsea.
Yeah.
You seen him?
Yes.
I got his mixtape.
No, he's on Twitter.
Our brother from the...
Yeah, he's in the crowd and he raps about Chelsea on Twitter.
Yeah.
So anyway, Shades, at Lutonian Stormzy, he raps in our mentions. He says, why exactly do you guys decide to ever put Paul Pogba as the second best midfielder in the league?
Just clocked who you're talking about. The little black cute, young you. Okay.
There you go.
That's a terrible at name, Shades.
Lutonian Stormzy. Paul Pogba, second best midfielder in the league.
Lutonian.
Yeah, I think that still holds up.
That still holds up. These men on the weekend are going, he's the best.
Pogba.
Yeah.
Second best. We voted him second best midfielder in the league.
I think he's, I still think he's top five. Definitely.
Yeah, he's definitely second best.
I still think he is. Like, obviously, like, if we're doing the form thing, he's not there. Not top two.
Nah, he's been but just ability, form. I think form-wise,
he's not top two.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah,
not
two
form
games.
But he played well against
listen,
us. Listen,
he's done enough, man. He's that's not. I'm not having that howler.
He got.
That's
not,
I don't think that's a howler. I don't think that's a howler at all. I think that holds up.
That's definitely not a howler. I don't think that's a howler.
Paul Pogba. Only Specs didn't have him in his top 10.
Yeah, but Specs had different people. He had Jeff Hendrick in the man there.
Yeah, man, he's high.
Specs had Guendouzi.
There you go.
Wow.
Don't you dare.
I had him eighth.
So. Rest in peace.
So what are you saying? Pogba being top two is not a howler. That's
I'm not having that. That's not a howler.
It's a howler.
Is that because I had him number two? It's a howler.
It's not a howler.
It's a matter of opinion. It holds weight. It could be argued. If it's
he's
arguable,
sick, but two. Come on, man.
Yeah, not
if it's
two,
arguable,
two,
if it's
two.
Arguable, how's it a howler? It's
exactly.
A matter of opinion,
it's not a howler.
It's not a howler.
That's your question.
No, no, no. But this show ends with that line.
It's
obviously a show about opinions. We can't say it's about opinions. It can't be a howler. Otherwise, nothing's
if
a howler.
I say
no,
that but majority rules. There's a lot of people out there who would agree with us.
So what are you telling me? He's not top two.
Pogba.
How many players in the midfield in this league have more natural ability than Pogba? Like,
there's not a lot in the world.
Then, what are you talking about?
Bro, that's like when Adele Tarrapt was here, bro.
He's one of the coldest.
Yeah, but he wasn't, though.
You wouldn't put him top
ability,
two.
Exactly.
But you wouldn't put him top two, though.
He's one of my favourite players.
No, ability-wise, ability-wise.
Left with it. It's so, you can't do that. That's an unfair comparison. You're talking about...
No, wait, I get it.
The comparison we're doing is Paul Pogba. So
I get you.
Let's stay specific.
But at the same time, though...
I rate Tarrapt.
Zimmy.
Yeah.
But he could never be... He wasn't even top 10.
You just showed me a Football Manager game. He's not playing for your team.
He's old, bro.
No, he ain't.
No, he's not.
No, he's not.
That's the next season.
Your first season.
No, it's not.
Second season.
And he's DM now.
Second.
It's my third season.
All right, I reject that howler, by the way. I reject that howler.
All right, so Lippy, can I ask you a question then?
Uh-huh.
You see how Pogba's performances have grown throughout the season?
Yeah.
If they continue to grow till May, and then Man United finish off second, for example, I don't know, Liverpool, Man City are first. Is it a howler then? And Pogba's had a huge influence in them being
second. He's not
second.
The best midfielder at his club.
Yeah, he's...
How can he be the second best in the league?
He's not the most influential.
The best midfielder.
I don't think he's the most influential.
He's not the most influential. Ability-wise, he is, bro. He is.
Ability-wise, he better than Van der Beek?
Yes.
Ability-wise.
Yes, man. Yes.
But why though?
Because he is. The
penance. I love Tego.
That's just skills and
switch balls. All those.
Yeah.
That's because of skills and shit.
That's football. You're talking about like.
Is Bruno better than Pogba?
Of course he is.
Not ability-wise,
man.
Ability-wise.
He is, though. He's better than him.
Like, you lot went crazy
Bruno
on the weekend.
You lot tried the whole Man United Bruno thing. It didn't bang. When the Man United with Bruno thing, that banged.
He's more influential, that's why.
That's why he's better. Now it sounds like you're doing top 10 rappers and you're trying to pass your words. Say what you actually mean.
Yeah.
I just said what I'm
saying. No, you didn't. All right, but you got to pick one of them tomorrow to play. Who are you playing?
Application.
Who?
Based on
this. With the You got to pick a player. Pick one right now. Tomorrow.
If I got to pick a player to play, I got to pick Bruno because he applies.
All right.
No, cool. I'm not going to lie. If you can
better.
Say Arsenal.
No,
better.
But here we are.
Better.
Saying
better.
Saying
better.
Done.
Better. Better.
You are confident, Bruno. Yeah.
That's all I ever meant.
You're out of your head.
No, you didn't. You said influential. That's just bars.
So Bruno hasn't influenced us.
He has, but he ain't.
Poet.
So is Paul Pogba.
Oh, my God. Bruno or Pogba.
Who's more influential?
Who's better?
Personally, I'm taking Pogba.
Yes, same.
I love the crowd, yeah. I love the crowd, but I reckon 3 years ago they didn't know fuck all about Bruno.
Bro,
give me one second. So a lot of the argument and is it a howler is stem from who's the most popular right now, and I agree it is Bruno Fernandes. But for me, in terms of ability wise, I prefer Paul Pogba every day over Bruno Fernandes. And in time, we will find out who's right or wrong. But I don't think it's a
more time for Pogba.
Enough.
Pogba just bought himself some more time.
He has. He's bored, so he's lucky.
He needs to go.
I don't think it's a howler.
Like,
I don't know if it's a defiant howler.
It's not a howler, man.
I think him being the second best midfielder is a howler.
I think it's a howler.
Okay, cool. So quickly,
I don't think it's a howler.
Quickly, just going around the table. If Pogba's not second best,
you voted for him third.
Nah, he loves.
If Pogba's not second best midfielder,
Jordy watched him on the weekend and said he's my favourite player ever.
Bro, Pogba's not the best midfielder at the team he plays for.
There's a couple midfielders that are better than
him. Just give me a name. It's just reflecting.
I'll put.
If it's not Pogba, who is it?
No, KDB. Jordan Henderson,
yep. Hendo's better than Pogba.
Yep. Yeah, they've all outperformed him. They have. Am I wrong?
Better than
they have. Obviously, but
Jack Grealish.
Yeah, Grealish. Ah, is it me?
Yo, you lot are Graham Souness in disguise, fam.
That's a howler.
Narratives.
Put all of these guys in the Man United team instead of Pogba. Man United the better.
Cold still. Well, Pogba's been playing recently. He's been quite influential.
Oh, the last two.
He has.
And I just want to see if this grows.
He influenced Man United to a 0-0 draw against Arsenal and a defeat against Sheffield United. I remember that influence.
I remember Bruno's influence.
Bruno's influence.
I'm not here screaming about Bruno. I'm just saying Bruno's carried Manchester United. Paul Pogba's an extra weight on Bruno's back.
If you want to do, he influenced them to a 0-0 draw, and Bruno carried United. Mm. Where did he carry us to in that 0-0 draw?
Nothing.
Bruno Fernandes had the best chance,
and he missed.
No, but Cavani did.
What?
No,
he did have the best chance.
He had a good chance.
Cavani had the two best chances in the game.
I was working during the game. I was working during the game.
That Cavani chance.
On it, Jordy.
Bruno should have scored.
All right. So okay, Lippy. Howler.
Yeah.
Skits.
No.
Margs.
No.
T.
Yeah.
Me no.
So we live in a democracy, so I understand you've got the largest voice, but no, it's not a howler, because four of us say no.
There
you
go. Judge rules. The two greatest men here, aka me and T.
Judge rules.
Loons.
Howler, innit?
Yeah!
Gang.
That's it, equalizer.
Next howler, according to Mustafa Salem from Twitter, Luke Shaw should have been placed higher in the left backs list. Respect Mark.
What's his name? Wait, hold on.
Say his name again. Sorry, was it? Wait, was it?
Say his name?
Mustafa Salem.
Mustafa.
Can I say something?
Shadran Mustafa.
Hey, Mustafa Salem, you are a howler. You are a howler.
Let me tell you why he's wrong. Because Luke Shaw has been rubbish up till now.
Yep.
Everyone needs to stop.
This season, we were talking off last season. Last season was good as
well.
Last season he was rubbish.
No, he that's why we need. That's why Brandon Williams plays.
Teague's neutral, man. What do you think?
This clashes with the Pogba.
I like Luke Shaw as a player. But the consistency has been an issue.
Yeah. You know what? Everyone goes off. Everyone goes off. Yeah. When he hit form against with Van Gaal.
Yeah.
And then he busts his leg.
But he broke his leg. So what do you want from him?
It was like 4 months, bro. It was like 4 months.
He's been at the club for what he's done.
He's been at the club for 7 years.
He's done nothing.
This is his seventh year.
He's been injured for about four of them.
He heard what you said.
No, he's been injured for about four of them years, and he's played good for two of them.
He's been injured for four of them years. Why is he so high?
Luke Shaw's been there for seven seasons.
And he's been injured for four.
So why is he so high?
What? Seven?
Yeah.
So why is he so high?
Fucking hell. I thought it was about four.
Potential.
Man, you bias, man. Just
we had him seventh. We had him seventh in our list. Of left back, so that was
behind, so he should be higher then.
So that was behind Bertrands. That was
seven
behind
seasons.
Yeah, seven.
Hold on. Let me find out who was behind though.
Van Gaal, 2014.
Oh, fucking hell!
Who did we rank him behind?
All right, so we had him seventh. That's behind Ryan Bertrands.
Better than Bertrands.
Yeah. No,
Benjamin Mendy.
He's better than Mendy.
I didn't vote for Mendy. We had him behind Lucas Digne.
Yes.
Cold.
It's true.
I don't know.
We had him behind.
I think Digne's was a howler.
Mm-mm. What?
You're crazy. This is why the crowd get onto you, because you move like you don't know football.
Take off the Prada hat.
Hold on.
He's living in them times.
This is why the crowd get onto you, because you move like you don't know football.
He's not even. He don't get the French pronunciation. He's Digne.
Why are you trying to make it sound like a Pokemon?
Because he's Digne. What has Digne done this season? Tell me. When was the last time you saw Digne play well?
He's injured, bro.
He's just.
When was the last time you saw Digne play well?
My answer is the same as his.
You lot are jokers. This is where it is, Tego. You see these, man, especially him. Go when on. A man is good on FIFA, he's good.
I've never used him on FIFA.
Team of the weeks.
He wouldn't be
so
a
Digne must be good. Because Digne's like.
I ain't paid all my team.
You're talking about
no, let's keep
that's
going.
Loons.
Let's keep going. There's more.
Right, yeah.
Digne's right, cold.
Hold on.
I don't even think he's better than
we also had him behind. We also had him behind Kieran Tierney.
Of course.
We had him behind Ben Chilwell.
Yeah.
And we had him behind Andrew Robertson.
Chilwell's dead.
Yeah, so that means Ben Chilwell. He either should be fifth. Or I don't know what you're saying. Fourth. You said Shaw's better than
Digne. I'd go fifth.
I think Shaw's better than Digne.
He should be fifth or fourth. So it's a howler. We had him.
Do you know what it is?
But Reguilon's coming since then.
Left backs in this league are shit.
It's a howler. We had him too low.
You see left backs here. You know, like when you play left back, it's not like centre midfielder. It's like three positions more time. It's one position.
We didn't have him too low.
And my man has had Williams as competition. It got so bad they signed Telles this season. If Shaw was the man that you think he is,
Telles coming and can't play, bro.
It doesn't matter. He's still there. Didn't he play like last game or the game before against Sheffield United? Like,
he was resting for the Arsenal game, you nutter. It's a squad rotation.
And what did Shaw do against Arsenal? Because Pepe had a good
time. Shaw played all right.
Shaw's not good. Atkins actually say it. Shaw is not good.
Shaw was
I don't know
Shaw
what you
right.
think
Shaw's
about
good.
Shaw.
Shaw's good.
But I know come summer, summer, you would want another left back.
Shaw's good.
Nah.
All right, you will. Wait, this
way.
What?
Shaw, I want another left back.
Hold on a minute. Let's crack open the Football Manager. Who's your left back on Football Manager right now?
Tellers.
Yeah, ain't sure.
I'm so sure.
Shaw's like Bellerin. Shaw's Bellerin level, bro.
That's a computer game. It's not the same thing.
He's so sure.
Yeah, he's gone. Long gone.
Sure, honestly, I can't lie.
That means it's not a howler. Tellers got me 20 assists last year.
20 assists?
20, bro.
Shaw looks a bit overweight. He looks, That's crazy.
I'll show you the numbers. I've got a lappy there.
He plays flying wing backs. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, they overlap.
No, yeah, that's what you did for my formation.
Did it work?
They're scoring.
I'm putting everyone to the side.
If your fullbacks don't overlap, forget playing the game.
How much does Shaw cost?
These man underlap. 30 mil. These man make their
Luke Shaw was 30 mil.
But for 7 years of service, it's not too bad.
No, but I'm talking about 30 mil how many years ago?
Like 2014, yeah.
How many years ago?
He was 18, 19.
So if that's an 18-year-old today, it might even be a little bit more. Sorry, I think Luke Shaw's a massive howler. That is...
I think we had him too low, though. I think he's better than Benjamin Mendy.
Yeah, he's definitely one of the better left-backs in the league.
Thank you.
100%. Thank
you. Top five, I'd say.
No, he is,
man.
He is.
When he's fit, when he's running, top five, yeah.
Do you know how bad Mendy is, bro?
All right, do you know what? I'll eat that howler. That's fine.
On Twitter, Grealish Season said it was a howler when Boat said that... Dan's name was Cabbage Dan, but he hasn't been back since.
Boat's a howler.
Titanic, man.
Jay Bricks made a good point. He said when we were making fun of Miles chatting shit about Lallana's Cruyff turn, that was true. Lallana's just a Cruyff turn machine, and we were making fun of him because I think it was more because it's Miles and it just came out of nowhere.
But Miles says he has the best Cruyff turn in football. What is that? How do you even know
that? I agree. That's what I was getting at.
How do you
at,
have
yeah.
that in your mind?
Miles is still going night school. In lockdown. That's crazy.
All right, here's one from Twitter. It's from Retta, at Retta Knows Me. Tego saying Salah is the most overrated player in the Prem.
Howler. Stand by it.
You know what? I think he heard you. Because he's moving mad.
But the kid of his... Tego has admitted on this show in front of me, not word for word, but he has said, yeah, the Salah thing was a howler. So you've admitted the Salah thing was a howler. Tego, do you know what you have? No, I haven't. Look at Tego, you managed it. Look at Tego, you read 100%. I remember it. Tell us more. Do you know why? Because I was back in Tego, like I kind of see where you're coming from. Then I had to admit, you know what, Salah's going crazy. And you admitted it on camera. I just need I remember it, but it maybe didn't make the edit. But I know that happened.
What do you reckon, boys?
I can't listen. Poet said on
his
kids. No, do you reckon that's the true story?
Well, Poet said on his kids. How can I go back on that?
Fam, I promise you.
Yeah, you can't.
He dismissed it. So Tego didn't go into a conversation about it. He just quickly said, it's with Hala. And he carried on moving. And I was like, raw.
I hear that.
How can you just dismiss
how,
it like
that's
that?
How Tego, that's how Tego admits
Hala. I would say, okay, Mo Salah is not the most overrated player in the Premier League. But what everything I said about him stands.
Nah.
So it's a howler.
Kante's better than him.
So it's a howler.
How is Kante better than him?
Kante's better than him.
Are you saying, listen.
That's just a statement. That don't
Poet is a lot of things.
Salah,
but liar is not one of them.
Thank you, Margs.
Yeah, right.
Nah, look. Mo Salah, now he's in a good run of form again. He went for a bad run of form. Still gets 50 shots a game, scores one.
Can I just say this? Salah, 4 seasons on a spin, 20 plus goals. Like, from the can't be
we've
overrated.
All got Twitter.
Like,
we've all got Twitter.
Come on,
we've
like,
all got
like,
Twitter.
Come on, like.
But do you know what it is? You got
stop showing off the trim.
Diogo Jota was going to hit 20 goals this year.
Nah.
Diogo Jota was on his way to 20 goals this year.
Nah.
Of course he was, because Klopp's system means those wide players bag goals.
Let's be clear.
Oh,
team.
Shit.
Yeah, Jota would have bagged on his way if he hit 20 goals.
And also, he hit 20 goals 4 seasons in a row. When I said it, he scored 20 goals 3 seasons in a row. I wasn't like discovering some, oh, let me tell you about the Salah guy. He's coming to Liverpool. He's overrated. No, bro, I knew what I was talking about when I said it.
You're lashing out, man.
I'm not lashing out.
This is a mess.
It's a howler.
It's a howler, man.
It's a howler.
What do you think? I didn't know he was going to score 20 goals this season.
Yeah, but bro.
It's a man.
But that don't mean that it's not calm.
Do you know what you need to do? You need to find a new most overrated player in the league.
Yeah.
That's Paul Pogba.
Listen, that's
he just said it's right that 8 seconds. So he's just trying to rattle people. Don't listen to him. He's just trying to rattle people.
That's why
you're lashing out.
I'm sorry. That's how you recover, though. That's how you. That's how you recover from a howler.
My point about Salah, I think a lot of it's lost in like that headline, like overrated, most overrated player in the Premier League. We were throwing out names who's the most overrated player in the Premier League. And I know Liverpool fans who tell
me
he's a frustrating player, misses a load of chances. If it wasn't for the team he was playing for, if it wasn't the system he was in, he wouldn't bag anywhere near as many of them goals. I watch him play, like, he's sick. Mo Salah is sick.
He's disgusting.
Mo Salah, and also, he's right. Also, he's an animal in that box, and the pace is nuts, and rah, 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 rah. When he leaves Liverpool, and if he leaves Liverpool in unceremonious circumstances, every one of these Liverpool fans is going to come back to me and go, yeah, he was wasteful. You know what? I wouldn't have trusted him. I wouldn't put my house on him one-on-one.
He's the best Premier League player ever. It wasn't Mane. Mane was better.
Facts.
He's the best Premier League Liverpool player ever.
He's not Jordan Henderson.
You know what I like? I like Salah because he's scoring and just not celebrating.
Do you know who I used to like? I used to like Theo Walcott.
He was all right.
Theo Walcott under Jurgen Klopp at 23 years old.
He's not Salah.
That would have been a madness.
He's not Salah. Yeah, you know what it is? I get it's the system. But they played that system. You look a lot. I can't believe this, bro. Bro, Salah. Watch Salah play football.
I can't believe we said football. Walcott.
Just watch him, bro. Just watch him. He's a very good footballer.
No, Salah's he's a murderer,
he's
you know.
He's a murderer. He's ruthless. That's what it is.
He's a serial killer.
If you give him an inch, he's taking that inch. He's gonna.
He's a driller. 100%.
Yeah.
100%. I rate him. People get fucked up. Think I don't rate him. I don't like him. I do. I'm just saying. Like when you talk about the best, that Pogba Bruno thing you're talking about there. When you're talking about that Pogba Bruno thing there, that's what I'm talking about.
He's the best player in the league.
That's what I'm talking about.
Who do you think is the best player in the league?
Best player in the league.
Who's the best player in the league then for you?
Kane. Son.
I have that though. I have Kane.
Kevin De Bruyne. Son.
Yeah, cool. But it's yeah.
I'm listening.
But I thought he was gonna try to say like Bruno or something. I was trying to catch you up. I was saying
Bruno and Salah cut from the same cloth.
Oh, I hear you there.
This next howler comes from Mo.
Fuck Mo. I'm joking, Mo. I thought it meant Mo Salah, innit?
Yeah.
Mo said one of the biggest howlers was Hudson-Odoi not being in top youngsters in the league.
Let's be clear.
No, it's not.
Mo, Callum Hudson-Odoi has taken long.
It's still taking long.
He's still taking long.
He's playing wing back right now.
I saw someone tweet the other day, Callum Hudson-Odoi is way better than we think.
Listen,
why are you tweeting that?
Do you know what Filthyfellas curse means? When this comes out, he's scored a hat trick or something.
Yeah,
but it doesn't matter. He's taken long, bro. Everyone he's compared against is smacking him up.
Yeah. Saka left him.
I totally agree, bro.
I had him top 10.
How much did Bayern bid for him?
Want to pay? They should have.
Yeah, it was free, wasn't it?
I think they wanted him on a free because it was running out of contract.
You know what's not fair, Because obviously he hasn't applied himself in the league, innit? So he hasn't done it. But you see that raw natural ability. The guy's one of the coldest. In his defense, though,
he smacked up his knee, innit?
I don't know, but he's cold. I've seen him play.
I just think they're using him wrong, innit?
Me, Margs, Steve-O, and Harry all had him in our top 10.
But Steve-O loves that guy.
All right, then.
But he ended 12th.
If Steve-O was here, he would be very angry at us.
But Steve-O should be angry at him because I think Hudson-Odoi has got bare ability. But if he doesn't consistently show it, I'm in my house. He's got nothing to do.
Yeah, man.
And he doesn't show. There's certain games he plays and does nothing.
And he caught that charge.
Allegedly, or he did actually.
Some people get time, some people don't. It's just Callum Hudson-Odoi gets time now, no?
George, what do I say after that, bro?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
What do I say? Like, what do you want me to say?
Listen, I didn't catch the charge.
Let's move on.
You caught the charge.
Callum, sorry, man.
Sorry, Callum.
Chelsea have got a very crowded left side.
You know what's funny? I liked him, I've proper liked him one game and then I clocked they're facing like Luton.
The Chelsea kids banged against Luton.
He's mad.
They got a crowded left side. They got Pulisic, they got Werner, they got him. And he comes third probably in that list of priorities for starting position. So now he's playing right wing back.
Well, Werner needs to make up his mind. That's all.
Well, yeah, that as well. Yeah.
Why don't Hudson just leave?
The only thing in the favour
of the argument that he should be in the top 10 is that A, Eddie Nketiah is ahead of him, hasn't had a good season.
Nketiah is ahead of him. I didn't vote for him. Did I vote for Nketiah?
You didn't.
Thank the Lord.
I didn't vote for him. Oh, you did.
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
I didn't vote for him.
Voted for him. Cheers, Mo.
Do you know what, though? Sorry to cut. Who's
voting for Nketiah?
This is going to go to back Tego's point from before. Before we, I don't know who was here, but me, Tego, and Lippy spoke about James Milner. Maybe it was in WhatsApp. And back in the day, for you to be a good young player, you had to bang. It wasn't down to this person bidding for you or any of these stories. You had to produce the goods. And I just think Hudson-Odoi, no disrespect to him, is surviving so much off like what people say about him and this and the bid from Bayern Munich. But when it comes to what you got to do, bruv, he's not really doing much.
It's not like, a howler that he wasn't in the top 10, but he better be in it next year.
Yeah, nah, it's nah, up nah, to nah. him.
To be fair to him.
What's that for, like, under 25?
Do you know what? He's edged his way into 10th.
Just about.
Has he though?
And Ketia's in there, bro.
Because Curtis Jones is.
Yeah, even Ketia's in there.
Curtis Jones has got a cracked top 10 now, though.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Because look, I think Loons
had him third, you know.
Oh, Neto's 100% in there. Neto's one of the coldest.
I think Loons had Curtis Jones like third or something.
He did, yeah. Yeah, Curtis Jones third.
Curtis Jones is cold. Neto's cold. I voted Hudson-Odoi in. I don't know if we've done it again. If I would, because like you're saying, because the way he's moving, but raw ability, I know what he's got, I know who he is. You know,
yeah, but guess what? He's taking long. How old is he? 19? Harvey Elliott's like younger than him, going mad for Blackburn right now. I reckon next season, if Harvey Elliott has a little time, he'd be in a conversation of top 10 before Hudson-Odoi, and it's Hudson-Odoi's fault. You can't blame me.
Wait, everyone remember that.
What?
I don't think that's fact.
Store. Everyone remember
I'm
that.
I'm not going to lie, that was a madness.
This could be a big one.
That was madness.
Like Harvey Elliott is going to be better than him.
Yeah. Everyone remember
that. Harvey Elliott will be in top 10.
No, you're saying Harvey Elliott's playing minutes, isn't it?
I think he's going to be in top 10 conversation minutes.
I'm just saying everyone remember it. Let's see. Important.
But he ain't going to get that in the Prem, though.
I'm not saying he didn't say he would.
Next year, Harvey Elliott will be, what, 18? He's young, fam.
Hudson-Odoi is how old?
I think he's 20.
Okay, so how many more years before we go, the potential's a bit like Martial? Like, I agree he's a good player. I agree he has all the talent in the world. But at 20 years old, I've seen 17-year-olds check the goalkeeper. I've seen 18-year-olds go mad. You're 20, bro. You got a nice trim, nice car. You're doing your thing. It's time for you to do something in the Premier League now.
It definitely is.
It really is time. All this conversation stuff is great.
And you know what it's like, because you can go from hot prospect to... I'm looking at Saka. I'm not looking at this. There's a whole.
The minute
Saka comes along, you forget. Yeah,
that's it. You're right.
How good are Chelsea at like bringing in a talent?
I don't think they're good at all. I think the.
Mason Mount's not making excuses.
Reece James is good.
He's a monster. Right now. He's a tank.
He was the one, though. Tank, so I think they make the wrong decisions. Because I think...
Reece James is amazing.
Like, what are they doing? Are they bleeding him in? Because if they're bleeding him in...
I think Reece James has got it all. Reece James is... I suppose it's preference on what you prefer as a player. Because I think Lamptey's super cold.
I prefer Lamptey.
Reece James is Lamptey kind of level. Like, he's as good as him.
The reason I say that, yeah, is... If they're bleeding him in, I think they're doing it too slow.
I just think Chelsea, they thrive off the transfer thing, obviously.
This season was a thing, just
the youths they bring through. Sometimes it's like, why? Like for me, Loftus-Cheek never ever made sense.
He's good at Fulham,
good
though.
But at Chelsea level.
He's not at Chelsea level.
Ain't he at loan at Fulham?
He's at Fulham.
Exactly, so just let him go. Why do you want him?
He's on a wage that people don't want to pay for right now.
That's a big Chelsea.
He's doing Magnum Burberry everywhere. Campaign.
Is that that Lucas?
Stop throwing Magnum everywhere.
Sir, shit.
That's is a
that
big
that? They got that. Do they still have that Lucas Pays on you?
Nah, he's gone.
Nah, he finally went.
Bro, the U was on that 70.
You know who's the longest serving Chelsea player?
I'm not surprised because no one's going to pay them.
He just went.
He was on 70 racks, bro.
Lippy, do you know what's so mad to me? Even when Frank Lampard left and everyone goes, they've done him bad. Like, you see Chelsea's circumstances. They are where they are. They haven't changed.
I'm not going to lie. I think it was unfair that they left.
Forget about that. But Hudson-Odoi, you're at Chelsea. Like, it's not unique to you. These are the circumstances.
Yeah,
it's always been the circumstances.
Leave.
Because it's either you play and perform or you go. Yeah. Like, I can't put you part of a top 10 list because your name is nice and by minute.
I think he should leave.
He does have a nice name, though.
He's a great name. His name is so dope. If he's well played, it makes sense. Callum Hudson.
I'm not a fan of double barrels.
Aren't you?
I'm not a fan of double barrels.
I like it when it's...
You look like you got a double barrel.
Odom Wenge Smith.
Has anyone told you you look like Odom Wenge?
Odom Wenge Smith.
This next howler comes from Yasho at Goodfella24Z.
Big up Yasho.
That's a terrible app.
Terrible.
Cavani being the worst signing of the season.
That's a howler.
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 But howler. Let's be fair.
Was he quiet up until that
time? Can I be clear? Let's be clear, yeah? Because I did think it was a howler too. And anyone saying it wasn't a howler is just hoping.
Still a howler.
It's just hoping. Because no one saw that he'd do this.
Nah.
For real.
Come on, man.
He scored 600 and something goals his career. Only man that scored more goals than him is fucking Messi and Ronaldo in the last four years. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what you mean, he didn't see this.
It's been
what,
say, Tego.
He's going to drop off the hill. What do you mean?
Tego. Let's be clear. You saw this.
I said everything I've said is true.
Let me tell you something. Tego, you said the realness. While the Arsenal match was on, he's having one of them games like his early PSG.
Yeah.
Where he tumps up all the little teams, comes up against someone a little bit serious.
The ball's bouncing
off his shins. He just can't do anything.
And, yeah.
And I think he does that. Goals, do you remember?
Season. What's thumping up the little teams? I think
He's doing everything he's brought to the table. He's exactly what I said at the time. You don't move like it's a howler. I'm saying
You spent 2 years chasing Jadon Sancho. You didn't get him. And then you gave the number 7 shirt to someone that we didn't have a club all summer. You could have signed him at any point. It does. It does.
It does matter.
And ultimately,
in hindsight, I was right.
You wasn't right. How much goals does Cavani scored?
He's been a good signing for us.
See, my beef with you, yeah, is you're right of hope.
It's hope. Mark, you're not moving like you've never seen Cavani play. You move like you don't know who he is.
Marks, I think you're saying
you move like
wrong.
He's old. Jamie Vardy's older than him. Mark, you're chatting shit. Mark, you're chatting
Cavani's
shit,
a good
bro.
Player, you know.
You're chatting shit.
Marks, Cavani's a good player, but Mark, it can still be bad business. It can still be bad business if it's a good player. Like, I think Cavani's great, but I think if you lot have had about 10 strikers in 7 years,
yeah,
blood, this is bad business. No, there's too many strikers.
You're right,
bro.
But one thing I'll say is one reason I really like Cavani at Manchester United is that I've had to watch Martial. Yeah. And actually having a nine.
Oh no, we got a substitution.
Oh, we got a sub in.
Yeah. I Skits. Oh, my brother. That's family.
I Skits.
That's my family.
I usually they bring a piece of paper with the tactics.
Yeah, it's look.
So what position are you?
No, I don't even do that.
He's Campbell.
I don't even do
you're
that.
Rasta, man.
What position are, are you?
Free roll.
All right. Left free roll.
So my thing about Cavani is, a lot of the reason I like him is because I've had to deal with watching Martial when I watch Manchester United. And it's not even a disrespect to Martial. He's not a nine. He doesn't have to move like a nine.
No, all disrespect.
He doesn't have to run channels like
all
a nine.
All disrespect. He wanted to be nine.
Yeah, but watching Cavani pull into these spaces and make the moves around the box, I'm like, wow, this is weird watching a Man United striker who really seems to know what he's doing in those spaces.
How many goals has he scored? Sorry.
About five.
Four.
I think it's more.
But let's be clear. Two Premier League starts.
How many league goals? Regardless, are you going to say it's a bad signing?
Say Cavani was a panic buy was not a howler. Because if any other club bought Cavani...
You never said it was a panic buy. You said it was the worst season.
No, but
worst signing
any
of the season.
Other club bought Cavani and they thought Cavani was going to do bits...
Was he the worst signing of the season?
Where was
is he
ranked?
The worst signing of the season?
Who is the worst signing of the season?
It doesn't matter. Is it Cavani?
Margs.
Could be.
Was he ranked number...
No. Wait, I want yes or no answers.
He could be.
Margs.
What now? Right now, Cavani's worst signing of the season.
Baby.
You are idiots.
I don't know what
he
done.
Was he ranked number one?
Oh, that's
a howler. It's a howler. Who is the worst?
William. William.
And Miles called it, and I didn't back it.
Cavani was ranked number two.
Ah, see? That's not a howler.
Number one was Donny van der Beek.
You'd be where you are without Cavani now.
We need a different option. We need a Cavani. It would have been good if we had a younger Cavani.
You had an Egalu though, which is like Cavani mold.
Stop it.
But Marks, this is my thing. Like up until the other day, I was literally going to say that. You had Egalo in your books, Egalo, Cavani, and Martial, and none of them are getting you 20 goals. So for me personally, if you sign,
it's not a reflection of the player. Over there for a minute.
Your club wants to get goals.
Egalo was there from last season. Martial hit 20 last year.
Yeah, but that's once in how long?
All I'm saying though,
I just think that's really
bad.
Something
about the way you lot play football though, why people aren't scoring. That's what I'm screaming. That don't make sense. It's something about the way you lot play football. Why
have you seen
the way
you lot play football?
Yeah, we're not scoring. Same thing.
Fucking bollocks.
No. Edinson Cavani has scored 4 Premier League goals this year.
Joke, man.
In 18 minutes, 618.
So what's that, about 9 games, 8 games?
14, but most of them are off the
blood
bench.
Blood
club. I'm saying
and
shit,
and Roberto Firmino's got 6 in 21.
Yeah, safe, 1,628 allow it, man.
Minutes. Let's be clear, though.
He's on Pepe numbers right now.
But I'm saying,
he's on Firmino.
He's on Pepe
You're
going
to like what I'm going to say, because I love Firmino this season.
This season,
I love him.
You can't compare him. He's doing a whole heap more.
I love this.
Might have 6 goals, but he's got assists.
You can't do that this year.
Yeah,
you can't do that this year.
You can.
Man United are above you.
Yeah, okay. It's that real.
Okay.
Edinson Cavani is doing work.
No, it's facts, though.
Bro, by the time
how can Firmino's work count, but Cavani's don't? You're chatting shit.
That's going to be a howler, brother.
Let's see, because this could be, because you know what, the last time, these
men were tweeting me when I'm saying United are not going to win the league. I say, when they were top.
Well, what's
happening now? This isn't about Liverpool. Edinson Cavani is not the worst signing of the season.
He isn't, but he's one of them.
It's a howler for me.
He's one of them, though.
No, he's not.
Five.
No, he's not.
All right, this next howler goes to Lippy. I decide I'll just go Lippy. I don't know why. It's random. It's random. The order.
Next time. The next eight is me. I'm sorry.
Ferran on Twitter says, Lippy put in Bruno ninth and his best players in the Prem list this season.
I Ferran. You know what I'm saying? Link, man. Car, you see that? Nah, brother. He come Emirates. He done nothing. Shut up, Ferran, dad.
So what? You'd have him as ninth still now? Ferran.
Is he still ninth?
He's still ninth.
I have him. He could get seventh now or something. No, I'm joking. All jokes aside, I don't like Bruno Fernandes. Great footballer. I fucking hate him. Yeah? Hate him. I don't like him, bruv. Car.
I'm not worried about Bruno Fernandes.
I'm not worried about him.
I think my little thing about him is like slightly marinating true. He's a big, small team killer. He'll kill
mid-table.
And
he's Cam Sanchez. What? He's Cam Sanchez, bro. Like, Alexis
come
Sanchez.
On, man. We got midfielders in the centre back. Like, you're supposed to be brushing us out of
Margs,
the atmosphere.
You have to wrap Manchester United.
You know, like,
that was the best goalkeeper in the world, man. The man just wrapped in his. Like, come on, man.
I hear you. Like, he's done his thing
against you, Zot. You're not in the cup no more. Allow it. Small team killer.
I'm going to let you finish.
No, don't let me finish. Just leave it alone.
I don't care about the FA Cup. I've said this 10 million times.
Oh, you also said you don't talk about football. What's that?
Neither do I.
One sec. You see, when it was for the 3 points, That Ole Gunnar Solskjaer would have died for at Anfield, my man was nil poor. Zero.
Yeah, facts.
People with glass houses shouldn't throw stones, bro.
Yes, we should.
Leave it alone.
We're the champions. Marks, you can't chat shit.
This is the only. I'm asking this question. I don't know the answer.
Ask him.
I haven't
ask
watched
him.
Man United recently.
Because they're shit.
But I've noticed Bruno Fernandes' interaction from an ignorant perspective. I don't see much goals
he's
and
shit.
Much assists like I used to see.
He's not shit.
Is he a man that if he's not getting stats, he doesn't really do nothing.
Nah,
bro.
No,
that's not true. That's not true.
He's a baller. I watch them.
You hit it on the head.
You know what?
Listen,
that's not
bro.
True. Why do you think his pass completion is so low? Because he's always trying. If we're going to do anything good, it's going to come through him.
See why that's BS.
I don't like him.
No, he's a good player.
But he's a baller.
He's a baller. He's vital to the good things that we do.
But he ain't in Kevin De Bruyne's atmosphere.
No way. No one ever said he's Kevin De Bruyne.
Kevin De Bruyne is the best.
No one ever said he's Kevin De Bruyne.
He's still the second best midfielder, attacking midfielder, call it what you want, in the league. Okay. He's top five on the planet. And I don't like him either.
You know what it is?
I can't remember what match I was watching you lot. I think it might have been a Palace match or something. This guy was playing like a dickhead, bro. Just dropped him and just thumped it. You lot won the match. His performance don't matter no more when you do them kind of thing. Zach Sanchez. Sanchez used to come at like a dickhead for an hour out of nowhere to mash up a fullback.
Is it not sounding like you're describing an Egyptian winger right now?
No.
Is it not sounding like you're describing an Egyptian winger?
Wait, does nothing.
Tego, listen. This is the only difference. He does it twice or three times as often as these other guys. You can't deny that.
Lippy, top nine, you had him ninth.
Yeah, man.
In the league this season.
He could get sixth now. He could get sixth now.
So it's
a
Howler.
Who's the five ahead of him?
Don't worry.
But you know what? Lippy's already sound like
you're trying to tell me there hasn't been five players better than Bruno.
Saka.
You see how
Saka's been better than Bruno this year.
Yes.
Man United are like top, you know.
If Saka played on Saturday, we would have brushed you. You'd be sitting there upset. And you know that. Bruno was there against Xhaka. Are you claiming shit? He done nothing. Nothing. You got David Luiz.
Nah, I hear that though.
You want me to rate him? Allow it.
Remember we argued the other week, yeah? I'm telling you, I'm standing on it. Mm-hmm. Bamford and Rice better than Saka this season.
Safe. You're wrong.
Lippy, welcome to the Wrong and Strong Club. Yep, I'm proud to have you, man.
Bruno,
wrong and strong. That's our proper saying.
When they finish third, everyone's going to act like this season never happened. Oh, but he's got 20 goals and fuck that.
Okay, I think we have to move on from Bruno Fernandes.
You'll probably come back later.
All right, this next howler comes from Muzzy on Twitter, Muzzy Fernandes. Loons said he'll take Pepe over Rashford with Vim.
Yeah, I would.
He's just
howler. I don't Rashford on the right.
Fat. That's so dumb.
Rashford's dog shit on the right.
He's dog shit on the right.
Bro, if I can't have Salah, I want a left footer that I'm going to say, watch his video, you know? Left footer, do what he does. You can't tell Rashford to do what Salah does. I can't do it. When so from my right
so
side,
you can tell Pepe to do what Salah does.
Did you? Let me ask you something.
You're full of shit, man. You're full of shit.
I stand on that.
Pepe over Rashford is a howler, bro.
You had Nicolas Pepe. You had him
obviously fifth, on the left,
sixth,
on the left,
and you had Marcus Rashford not in your list. So it's not about left and right.
It's not about left and right. You're chatting shit.
No one asked you anything. It was about the right hand side, bro.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't about the right hand side. It was left and right hand sided wingers.
I'm going to own up.
You never put Rashford in your top 10 and you put Pepe in there. It's a howler.
There's no proof.
It's a howler.
I'm going to tell you my reasonings behind that. I didn't put Rashford in my wingers list because he's not a winger for me, you know? I would, like, if I had Marcus Rashford in my team...
He'd be the nine.
He'd be
it's a brand new argument.
I like it.
He'd be my backup nine. I won't play wide. He'd be my backup nine.
Hey, Tego, he came with a game plan.
And I'm putting that you.
I'm in the big game
starting. George, look at me. You black manned him off and you put him on the flank.
Yeah,
and you robbed us of one of the greatest names.
No, Briggs eat him off.
You know that's true. You know that's true.
When this landed, he does his thing on the flank. And the only thing that I don't rate yet is when they keep shipping him out to the right and knowing that he's not effective out on the right. On the left, he does his thing, bro.
Listen, George, you know, when Rashford came, he could have been one of the best nines this country has seen. That's facts.
100.
He was fucking 100. Up.
Don't look at
big
me.
Big boy defenders. Am I wrong?
These men chat like they're in the coaching team, they've been with England. Marcus is his cousin.
Wait, Dan.
This season, Marcus Rashford in the Premier League has 7 goals and 8 assists.
That's disgraceful.
He's got 6 goals in 6 in the Champions League.
That's bad. No, that's good.
That's disgraceful.
7 goals. 6 and 6.
And 8 assists. But you know how many goal involvements that is?
21 games. 15.
Wait, let me tell you something.
15 goal involvements in 21 games, you knock.
That's great.
Can't you do math?
Hey, listen. Well done. That's
not a lie.
That's
are you stupid?
And he's giving out school dinners. You man are idiots.
Hey, listen.
Pepe, get out.
Hey, Poet.
This is crazy.
Hey, listen. Let me say something quick. If you told me that mash up Arsenal at Old Trafford will have 7 league goals at Christmas a couple years later. I say you're chatting shit. That
he's playing wing though.
So if no, whoa. Exactly. But he's being wasted.
Let me take it to Dan.
He's got 8 assists. Though.
Let me take it to Dan. Dan plays the most consistent football here.
Nah, I'm semi pro books.
No.
Chat to me, bro.
I'm not semi pro books.
We need to bring Dan in anyway. He's offered nothing so far.
They're going to say Lippy's being biased. That's Dan, I want to know this, yeah? At your team, as their player, that's very good. Very, very, very good up front, yeah?
What's your team called?
Very, very good up front, yeah?
What's your team called, by the way? And what league do they play?
There's someone that is like a better nine. The player might be a better footballer than the nine, but the nine's better at playing the nine. So you stick him wide. That's what Rashford, that's
but
me.
But you have to remember,
that's
at my
me.
Level, we've got Ed McKenna can go in the 10, but it's always going to be Xav going long.
Listen, let me tell
you. Listen.
As you know, I play for Hatfield Town, semi-pro level, you get me?
Yeah. Seven minutes.
I'm a fullback. We've only played 6 matches this season because of COVID.
How much have you played?
Listen, the last 15 minutes of play, I was up front. I was. And I got an assist. No, listen. Let me tell you something. Because within the match, I had the attributes, what was needed to get the 3 points.
Yeah.
So I'm number 2 up top. What?
Yeah. Did you get the 3 points?
We did, because of me.
So let me ask you this, as you played at right back, have you played against a wide player that you know is not?
I just mash him up. Yeah. I played against some kind of Rashford. That can't do nothing.
Rashford's got 15 goals and 10 assists, all comps by this now. Season. And you're telling me he's rubbish.
So did the winger that I played against.
He's a smoking.
You know what he did against?
He's a shit.
Pepe's just not.
That's why I'm here.
Pepe don't. Rashford has 15 goals, 10 assists in 33 games, all comps this season. Pepe does not.
Pepe is a howler. It's a howler.
It's a howler.
What's he going to do? He's going to do nothing.
I believe that. Me, I'm not going to, again.
You're ignorant. Wrong and strong.
I'm not ignorant.
Welcome to the wrong and strong table.
Don't quote me on this.
You're sitting on the wrong and strong table.
Marks, listen.
Check Pepe's stats, though.
I think he's got the most goal contributions for Arsenal with goals and assists this season.
Nah, all comps.
I don't know. I don't know. I don't think so.
You better not.
No, take a look.
But I know.
I rate Pepe a lot, man. I like Pepe. I like him. I like him a lot.
You know who made no key passes in the Arsenal match?
Who?
Bruno Fernandes.
What?
He made less key passes
than Willian.
And I'm a dickhead for putting him back. I remember your name, bro.
Pepe's got three goals and no assists in the league. He's got three goals and three assists in Europa League, but we're not counting.
Of course you've got to count that. It's a tournament, it's football.
It's Dundalk. They played Dundalk twice.
So you're trying to tell me them Irishmen ain't got heart?
Wait, let's stop. Split these two up, please.
We all agree, Luke.
Yeah, it's carnage.
We all agree.
Next episode as well. Go ahead again.
We all agree Loons had a howler. Just on the other side. We all agree Loons had a howler there.
Yeah, definitely.
This next one comes from The San or Thessen. I don't know.
Come give me another one.
Unfortunately, he said y'all in his. He said when y'all laughed at specs for no reason about Jack Grealish.
Well, go watch American football. What was I cunt about y'all?
I don't recall.
But yeah,
just
but
to give it context, we don't laugh at what specs is saying. We just laugh at specs.
What about the picture with the chicks? I need the crowd to understand this. When Specs says stuff that's right, I still disagree. Specs, I hate it.
Specs,
yeah. It's facts.
Specs had him number one best midfielder in the league.
Fuck what? Specs. That's a howler.
But he shouldn't.
That's a howler.
Also, what is Grealish? Because is Grealish really
he's
now,
English?
Is
he's
a,
English.
No, is he a mid? Is he a midfielder?
<He's Irish.
laughs> Like I'm saying, is he a midfielder? He plays in a front three.
On the left flank of the midfielder, though.
Is it?
I'd have him on the left flank.
Him from the left with that
overlap. If he
overlap.
Come to my team, I want him on the left.
He's just one that tucks in.
Literally your team.
If he comes to Arsenal, I want him on the left.
The overall point is that Specs had him number one, and while Specs is probably doing something for effect there.
Yeah, and John Fleck and all these other weird people.
Yeah, it's Ruben Neves and.
But that's not
Neves. Yeah, Guendouzi, had Hendrick. Yeah, it was a weird list.
Guendouzi, I hear it.
Has Jack Grealish surprised people? Because Boat didn't vote for him, Margs didn't vote for him, Dan didn't vote for him, Poet didn't vote for him, Lippy didn't vote for him in their top 10 going into the season.
Because he was sent a mid though, and for me,
I
didn't vote.
For me, he doesn't have a position.
That's not why you didn't vote for him, because
I didn't put him in the winger one either. I even said it in the thing, I'm not putting him there. He plays on the left.
Grealish is one of the best
winger. I didn't put him
Grealish is one of the best players in the league, though.
He is, but at the same time,
I wouldn't put him as a centre midfielder.
Yeah, he's not a centre midfielder.
He didn't vote, so it doesn't matter.
But he's not. When has he played? Exactly.
Get him.
But you're not trying to make us look nuts.
We're not putting him in. But I would only say it's because I think I had a conversation with Tego, and I've always wanted to see him number 8. And then when I watched him, he played forward, so I hadn't watched him enough to know where he plays.
I don't think he could do eight anyway. I think eight requires too much work.
You see me?
You reckon so?
He's a captain, you know. He walks a lot, man.
Shall I tell you what it is? I admit it, innit? I've only watched Villa against the top sides, innit?
Yeah.
And he's been on the left there, and he's completely fucked up the right back.
Yeah, every single game.
You understand? So to me, it's like, but he's not a winger, though.
And you can't have him in the centre.
In the middle, I don't think he would work.
Do we all agree that if he goes to a top six team, whoever that top six team is, they're in the game now?
Villa are top six team.
I don't know.
He starts at every top six. I wouldn't say he starts. Because he hasn't got a position, I would not say
he wouldn't start at Liverpool because of Mane and their midfield. Potentially.
Their midfield, that's a big statement. Their midfield.
Bro, Fabinho.
I'm just saying he's not working harder than them. They don't play
he's
a 10.
He's not doing more than
I agree.
Than
I agree.
He's not doing more than that.
He has to be a 10.
What's he doing that? He's going to come in and do genie work or Hendo work.
He's a free roll, man. You give him a free roll.
I think it's only Liverpool.
You guys need to calm down on that table.
Impossible.
You both just
Grealish comes in and does Hendo work.
You guys need to calm down over there. Loons, you need to not talk over people.
I'm not saying that.
Do you know what? I like talent, yeah? But everyone knows my thing about talent. I don't love it until it's fulfilled.
Is he better than Mason Mount?
Bang, I love that.
Yeah,
like, do you think he's better than Mason Mount?
What?
Yes.
I'm asking him a question.
Oh, honestly, I think they would work great in the same team.
No, I don't think so.
I don't know. I think if we're talking pure talent.
One or the other.
Just talking talent.
One or the other.
If I'm going one or another, I'm going Mason Mount.
Whoa!
What? Whoa. Hey, listen, you know if you man don't watch Mason Mount,
Tego, your thoughts, please. Your thoughts. Because you know you're my guy for the answers.
Holy
what do you think of that?
I love Mason Mount. But I'm going Jack Grealish. I love Mason Mount.
What are you
doing? Mason Mount can play on the left as well, by the way.
No, yeah, he's the same kind of player.
If you want a slow lefty.
Mason's good as well. Let's not get it twisted.
He's solid. He's five years younger than him. Five, 6 years younger than
him. Grealish is cool, but I'm saying for the type of football, remember, man, I'm a technician. For the type of football my team is playing, I can't really have.
Who wants the worst football?
I need a Mason more than I need the language stylish guy.
Jack is teched up.
He's teched up.
Yeah, I'm not saying it, but he's saying language. I know what he means. I'm not saying he's got walking moments.
Even though Tarak's next.
No. You know what? I'm going to make him. I'm going to make damn right here. Look, this is what I'm going to make damn right. There was a Mason Mount made his first start last season here.
Yeah.
And I think his first goal, he done a higher press. He just chases the ball down. And there's Grealish has moments where he's gonna walk. He's gonna have them walking moments because they're both luxury players.
Man.
But Mason Mount is a bit more hungrier. He's Mason just gonna chase more.
Can I just say something? That's not fair. I've seen Grealish. This is why I don't agree with that.
A luxury player. Grealish could be if he goes to a top team. I'm not gonna lie. Potentially, but
Mason he's got Mount. That. He's his personality.
Yeah.
The thing is, you see Mount. Yeah, you've just seen him. What Derby, I imagine, and then Chelsea. Yeah. And that story he had as Chelsea was nice. But you see Grealish's story, don't underestimate it. Like he wasn't getting beat 4-0 by Arsenal in the FA Cup final.
Got punched in
like
the face.
Like he didn't have to go championship, punched in the face in the Birmingham. He punched man in the, he got punched in the face. He's then, no, he's got punched and then scored the winner. And he's the captain. That's the derby.
I'm not saying, I rate Grealish.
Grealish knows responsibility.
Uncle Poet.
I'm saying, of course, Grealish, you can tell he's a leader. You can tell he's confident. Bro. He's the guy, bro. You've seen him, bro. He's linking two things. You get me? Like he's in the bed. Like he's
kind of
mad.
He had Aki and Sorbitz an hour after that picture. Like, however, come on.
Exactly. So I know from that picture he's ready. But for me, for the team I'm playing, I need my engine room going mad. And Mason Mount.
You'll never see Mason Mount do a picture like Grealish ever.
And do you know what? I think it's. I'm not sure if Mason Mount's got a missus, but I think Mason Mount's capable of a picture like that. I think we could in the future.
You know what, Dad? Dan, I apologise for acting like you're a madman. True, I beat you in the shot power challenge. That's why I think you're shit.
But it's gone.
What? He's got more power than you,
bro. My thing didn't work.
Pause.
But it wouldn't work. Like there was no score.
I know what.
96.
You're just a whipper, ain't it? You got no pace.
He's a finesse man.
Do you? All right, cool. I'm just going to ask you just as a genuine thing. Do you think he's got more power in the shot than him?
Well, 100%. The test
I'm asking. No. Forget what the test is. Do you think?
What?
Do you think he has more shot power?
I'm the fastest on Filthy.
I don't know that.
I've proved that. Exactly.
What do you think?
Pace, speed, bro, and strength equals power.
I ain't run next to you yet, so we can't say that.
Yeah, it's true.
Are you faster than Steve-O?
Let me ask you an honest question then.
You're not faster than Steve-O. You're faster than Steve-O.
Have you rolled Z?
Let's go next.
Have I rolled Z? Next. That's part, bro. You see if I'm 1-0 lock.
I mean a shot.
Bro, you know I'm both footed. You know if I slap this ball with my left foot, it's going, it might not stop, bro.
Have you kicked it over the bar and it's gone right into the back of the stand?
Fast.
Bro, I've lost balls, bro. Plenty of balls.
Okay, that's what I know. So you're an inaccurate shooter.
Hey, listen. Let me tell him something. Hey, Margs. I said the same thing to Steve-O. You don't have the Samatta type to see me. Bro.
What the fuck?
God didn't bless you with the tools to be quicker.
What's God do with Grealish?
No. I love this. Because this is what I came for, really.
I knew it.
You ain't faster than me.
I'm fucking fast.
We can leave best footballer out of this combo completely. Luckily, I'm the fuck. Listen, we've proven. Tego, what's the proven thing? I'm the fastest. I've got the hardest shot.
Did he beat Steve-O in a race?
What's
in an actual race?
Yeah, you got gigs.
I blasted Steve-O.
But that's fine. But do you know what you don't have? You don't have talent.
I swear you got 10 years on him or more.
I'm just saying, I know.
What did you just say?
You don't
have. Chill. So what's the talent?
You know what you don't have?
Talent.
So how do you have it? It's not. I can see when the ball's coming at you, I know there's not talent. It's maybe this ball's going to get trapped. Or maybe it's not.
Lippy,
anyone who's a baller.
Talk to me.
When
talk
the ball comes.
Hold on, Dan. Lippy, did you say in the group that you were the best in your school?
I was the best in my school. Easily.
Bro, what school is this? I was the best in my school. What school is that?
That's it. Brother, let me tell you something. Filthy crowd. See, this is what these not do. They be loud. Go to my. Hey, who do you play for?
I play for whoever I want.
Say nothing. Poet, who do you play for? Say nothing. Who do you play for?
Brentford Rejects.
Who do you play for? Say nothing. Who do you play for?
Ex Norwich.
For Hatfield Town.
How many minutes you got this season? Brother, how many minutes have you got this season?
I don't know.
Wait, can I say this?
I don't know. What's 90 times 3? Say on camera, on the mic, you were the best in your school.
I'm the best footballer on Filthyfellas. Anywhere I've been, I'm the best footballer. I'm the best. Listen.
He caught him.
Because you know when Pro will pop up, I went to school with Lippy.
That's bare man.
Any semi pro team that wants to give me a whiz, please holler at me.
Lippy, I've been waiting to ask you that question on camera for a while. Were you the best in your school?
Definitely. From year 9, I was the best in my school.
I wasn't the best.
I was the best in my school.
Your whole school is watching this.
What's his name?
Brother, do you know who went to my school? No, I went Claremont. Stuart Pierce's school, yeah?
Stuart Pierce!
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Stuart, he's the most famous footballer to come from my area.
So when you were in school, he was the best, you were the best player.
When I was put this way, Google him, the best you after me was a you. No, his name was Jordan Brown. He used to play for Arsenal and West Ham. He was a couple years younger than me.
So, can I ask a genuine question?
And his brother, Raphael Brown, that was 2 years older than me, used to play for Chelsea. But I took over from him.
What would you say are your best attributes?
Football.
He was in my year.
Did you play for Middlesex County?
Yes, I did play for Middlesex County.
The last baller from his area is Stuart Pearce.
No, it's not. It's Raheem Sterling. It's Raheem Sterling. So now what?
Oh, it's Raheem Sterling. From your area. That's from Miles' area, not yours.
Huh?
It's from Miles' area, not yours.
It's Brent Barra.
Stuart Pearce was
from Shepherd's Bush. You can't claim everyone.
He went to Claremont.
So what are you claiming? Are you claiming everything? Your school, your area, what is it?
We've done enough.
I just want to close this by saying, I think everyone knows and can feel I'm the best player.
No, we've done enough for now.
Niggas didn't even play for their borough.
We've done enough on this.
What are you trying to prove, quickly? What are you trying to prove?
I'm the best.
How did you do that with no touch, though? That's what I want to know.
1 second, you don't stop shouting about
it. See the one that you posted? The one you posted?
This guy's hoping.
When the ball came out the sky, it's a simple maneuver to get that ball 1 yard ahead of you, side foot into the thing. The thing that Loons tried to do, but he knocked it 15 yards.
Oh, so what did I do? That's how I
done it. But you did like some kind of stump on the ball.
One set. Everyone's on to me. Wait. No, everyone's on to me. 11 steps. Mo Salah took 9.
Show me how I stepped on the ball. Watch it.
Show me how I stepped on the ball.
Makes you play for your borough and your county school days, and it makes you semi-pro in your late 20s.
This a man he's got no talent, but he's got stats.
Because put it this way, who do you play for then? We don't know.
What do you mean, Madonians?
Shall I show you the?
You know I can play for anyone I want, don't I?
All right, this one came from YouTube. It came from Harry C 0380.
It's Harry Pinero in disguise. Fuck.
Yeah, Harry. And the biggest howler to him was Loons calling Bergkamp overrated.
I knew it was Loons.
Calm. I stand on that.
Yeah,
I stand on
that. Standing on duty.
Overrated.
Because if man's not gonna let me, if man wanna talk over me, go now. Everyone speak.
Him standing on that is like standing on diarrhea barefoot summertime on marble flooring.
On a level, bro. You said you're standing on that, bro, and you're still not as tall as Chucky. This is poor, bro. Like, you don't understand. Like, that point
Chucky,
is
I don't know Chucky.
You don't deserve that.
I don't know him, so like, that don't mean nothing.
He's like
I get it, but Magnum short on taller.
Dan, your turn.
My turn.
Do you want to have anything to say on that, my opinion?
For him.
Do you know what?
Jordy said it's still not as big as your fridge.
You see me, yeah? I'm going to stop talking on players that I didn't watch that much of, yeah?
Okay, Pigo.
My turn. Yeah, it's a howler.
Howler, go on. It's not what I'm... Back to you, Tego. I'm not asking you if it's a howler. Have you got anything about my opinion?
It's a howler. That's an opinion. That's a howler as well. That's a double howler.
Mark, man.
Footballing legend, Arsenal legend, exceptional footballer.
Not your phone.
Howler.
Yeah.
You know what I just got from my club?
What does that say? Give me your drops? Details so you can give it so I can be on Football Manager. Everybody shut the fuck up. I'm the hardest on Filthy. I'm on Filthy Mac.
Hold on.
I'm copying you.
Their allowed rate is going to be a six.
Hold on. You think it's a vibe? Watch when, hey. Watch when we see his stats.
Yeah, yeah.
No, he's on there. He's on there. He's on there. All right, Lippy, what's it? Lippy, grab a seat.
I've got first touch seven.
Lippy, congratulations. You're now the third person on Filthy to be in Football Manager.
The first person from Northwest on there. Miles ain't on there.
No, you're the third person from Filthy to be in Football Manager.
Who's the first two?
Steve-O.
Yeah. And you. Well, you two are all did on there. I must have been on there anyway.
From the 90s.
Go on, Burkamp, land your... Lippy, let him land his meaty Burkamp.
It's not meaty because you can't do that. Don't do that. Don't make it like it's meaty. It's my opinion, yeah?
It's meaty.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying your opinion can be meaty. I'm not saying this one is.
No.
No, it is.
It's powerful meaty.
Even I'm telling
you. I let you all go. So you can't say it's meaty before I've gone, innit? It's insane. Okay, this is what I'm going to say this now. The go-to goals for people I've got for Dennis, or the go-to highlight reel they have got from Dennis Bergkamp is either the Argentina goal. Anyone name me the goalie and any of the defenders other than Ayala that was playing in the Argentina defence, yeah? 1 second, yeah? And name me a team in the top six or top four or a team you actually rate that he scored against, because I know you're going to go to Newcastle and Leicester. I mean, I've got stats.
Manchester United, 1 second, Liverpool.
He scored in 17 games against Spurs, he scored twice. In 17 games against Liverpool, he scored once.
Yeah.
Like he weren't that guy for me. That's all I'm saying.
You see how had you tech, love Firmino.
And you're allowed to have tech. Loads of good players had tech, but the homeboy just weren't there when it really mattered. He made the move to the equivalent of Barcelona of the time at the time, which was Inter Milan. They were the equivalent of Barcelona. Homeboy played there 2 seasons, got like 5 goals.
How
Homeboy
are they equivalent to nothing. Barcelona? What
Homeboy
are you talking
was
about?
Basic for me. He's a bootleg Baggio.
Nah,
bootleg
Pepe Signori.
Bootleg Cantona. That's what I believe. And I stand on it.
Stop.
Didn't fly. Didn't do nothing. Didn't do nothing. I stand on that.
You should have started
with
that one.
Not better than Gianfranco Zola.
That's where I would have accepted.
Not better than Gianfranco Zola.
I reckon he was in prison at the time he was playing. Because your chat is shit.
I stand on that.
You're
done,
bro.
Javier Zanetti was in that defence. All right, these were the... We're going to have to do another episode of Howlers because it got too animated. There were too many substitutions.
Ethnicity.
And
Italian.
Lippy's filling in his Football Manager details. I don't know what his hit and wit are going to be. Subscribe to the channel and listen to us on stereo this week.